Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube, and I was working on some stuff in Power Query. This is in the query editor, and there were several queries, right? Some were connected to an Excel file, some were connected to SQL Server, and I wanted to change something in every one of those queries, and I was like, how would I do it? This is gonna take a long time. And then I ran across something that just kind of blew my mind, and that's what I'm gonna show you in this video. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Like I said, I was working in Power Query and I had lots of queries, some from Excel, some from SQL, and I needed to change the connection string. That's what I really needed to change. I wanted to make it dynamic. Instead of using the hard-coded server name or the hard-coded path to the Excel file, I wanted to switch it to a parameter, but I had several queries and I was gonna have to do them one by one. And I'm thinking to myself, Patrick, you're not lazy, you're just efficient. There's gotta be a better way. So I tinkered a bit and I ran across something. And that's what I wanna show you in this video, all right? So enough of all this talking, you guys know what I like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Head over to the query editor. So I'm gonna go ahead and open the query editor. And you can see I have several queries right here. And if you go to the source, you can see they're all pointing to this Excel file. They're all pointing to the Excel file. Or you can open up the advanced editor and you can see they're all pointing to this Excel file. And what I wanna do is I wanna switch them to use this parameter. So if the path changes, if I make a Power BI template file, somebody can quickly update this parameter and it'll automatically load the data from that location. I thought about a couple of ways to do it. You can go into the advanced editor, like I said, and replace the hard-coded path with the parameter. But again, I have to do that for every one of the queries, not efficient. And then I said, oh, well, I can go right here and click on the gear and do it here. And I was thinking again, I have to do that for each one of the queries, not efficient. And I was wrecking my brain. Then I had a thought. You need to enable something before you do this. So I'll show you how to enable that. But I have this way that you could do it like a bulk update. Check this out. Before you get into this, what you need to do is you can either go into the query editor, you can click view and you can choose always allow. And so this is always allowing the parameterization of the connection string. Or if you're in the desktop or the query editor, you can go to file, choose options and settings, select options. Here in the global section, choose Power Query Editor, and you can check this box. Either way, it'll give you the same result. So go ahead and click okay. And then what you do, instead of clicking the gear for each one, you go home in the ribbon and you locate the data source settings. You find that data source. So mine in this case is an Excel file. And at the bottom, there's a couple of options. Choose change source. Change source. Because we've enabled always allow parameterization, you'll have this little drop down. If you don't see that drop down, you need to go enable it, right? So go enable allow parameterizations. Click this little drop down arrow and choose parameter. And then you can see I have a CSV file as a parameter, but I also have my Excel file. So I'm gonna click the drop down and choose my Excel file name. Click okay and click close. Now it's important that you specify the path to the file, right? Wherever that Excel file exists. And now if I go to customer and choose source, you'll see it's updated. And I was thinking to myself, is it gonna update all of them? So of course I checked. I went to employee, I clicked source, and boom, it updated it. I went to product, I clicked source, and boom, it updated it. And then I call Adam. I was like, Adam, dude, I gotta show you something. And he's like, what? So I showed him, and he was like, what the fridge? Did it change all of them? I was like, yeah, it changed all of them. And you know what he said? That's gonna make a good video. So that's why you're seeing this video. But then I thought, will this work for other sources? So I said, well, let's try my favorite source. Let's try the old trusty SQL Server. Check this out. I have another PBIX file here where I'm connected to SQL. I'm gonna go into the query editor. And so I set this one up where it's completely broken, right? It's just completely broken. So I'm gonna go manage parameters. I'm gonna create a new parameter. I'm gonna call it my SQL Server, change it to text. And then I'm gonna just put a SQL Server name in here and click okay. And then I'm gonna go over here to data source settings, and there's the data source. I'm gonna say change source. Remember, you gotta turn this on, choose parameter, SQL Server, click okay, click close. Watch these yellow, look at them going away. Guess what I did? If you go to the source here, you can see instead of the hard-coded SQL name, SQL server name, it's actually the parameter value. So whatever value I put here, as long as there's a corresponding AdventureWorks database with the same schema, I may have to provide my credentials, but it's just going to work. That's bananas. Can we say this is insane amazing, right? It blew our minds, right? Have you guys seen this? Did you guys know about this? I'd love to know. Are you doing this a different way? Again, I'd love to know. You guys know what I want to do. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. You like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.